like to tell you about simple present tense, and I will introduce our group member. My name is Redita Puspanastiti.
My name is Ayu Andrianisi.
My name is Nana Aditya.
And I Adi Nugraha.
So enjoy it.
Hello, welcome to the next section. Here I would like to tell you about the simple present tense. Simple present tense is mostly used for regular and repeating events, and also to express the activity that happened in the present. Here I would like to tell you about adverb of time that used for simple present tense. For example, like always, seldom, usually, every day, on Monday, on Sundays, often, never, and so on.
Okay, now with me in third session, and I would like to explain all you guys the positive statement of simple present tense. Now, in this occasion, the simple present tense actually have two types of positive statement. They are the verbal types and the non-verbal types. So, if you want to make this positive statement of simple present tense, I would like to tell you the pattern of the simple present tense. Now we have the pattern. The first pattern, we have subject plus verb 1 plus object, and the last one is the adverb of time. And the second pattern, this is for non-verbal one, you have subject plus to be, and usually it is adjective. Now since we used to be as the pattern of the simple present tense, and I would like to inform you how many to be that we have for simple present tense. In here, I have written down for you guys, and this is the list of the subject, and in the left side, the list of the to be. If you want to use I, you have to use am. You, we, they share the same to be. They are. And see, he, it said the same to be as well, and they are is. Then, for the example of the positive statement of simple present, I have written down the two sample of simple present tense. The first, this is the verbal one. I use the verb to be as the verb. Now, let's take a look at this. I study English today. We have I as the subject, we have study as the verb one, we have English as the object, and we have today as the adverb of time. Now we come to a second example. This is a non-verbal one. I choose she is beautiful. We have subject she. Because the subject is she, we use to be is. Then we have an adjective beautiful, so the complete sentence becomes she is beautiful. Now I think that's all about the positive statement of simple present tense. See you next.
Hi, come back again for the third section. I would like to tell you about interrogative in simple present tense. Interrogative in simple present tense have two types, verbal and non-verbal. The pattern of verbal is do or does, plus subject, plus verb 1, plus question tag. And for non-verbal, to be, plus subject, plus adjective, plus question tag. For example, does Abi work today? For verbal, and for non-verbal is he beautiful? Thank you.
Okay guys, I want to tell you about a negative simple present tense. The pattern is subject plus does or do plus not plus verb 1 plus adverb of time. And then non-verbal, subject plus to be plus not plus adjective. The example is she is not read a book every day. She, subject, does not is pattern and read this verb 1, and a book is object, every day is adverb of time. and then nonverbal. He is not smart. Subject and is to be, not pattern, and smart is adjective. And then why this sentence does and why this sentence do? Because the ending es usually added to subject that considered as that es to edit the considered as, and then the term singular person.
Thank you for watching in this section about the simple present tense. Hopefully you will get a lot of information about this section. Don't forget to for like and comment our video.
And subscribe also.
See you!